Back in the USA. All right. So what's that shadow? That's annoying. Oh, it's gone. All right. This is my phone. I'm not going to show it to you. Go away, phone. I'm here. I flew into Korea. I was there for 4 hours, and then that kind of sucked, actually. Koreans might be awesome, and Korea might be awesome, but at the airport, everyone had a chip on their shoulder. It seemed like, you know, when I would go to get some food or whatever, it was kind of like, why are you interrupting my conversation with my coworker? What do you want? Why do I have to give you a sandwich? And why don't you speak Korean? That was my impression of the airport in Seoul or Incheon. So take that and forget it. Right. So I went to Goodwill. I got in. My friend flew to Seattle. My friend picked me up and we passed all these Goodwills and we ended up going to 4 of them. So I got to do that after having not slept for over 60 hours straight. So that was sweet. And I found this. I like plug-and-play games a lot, and I guess I collect them, but I'm going to have to start being careful because I found some I didn't buy. Blah, blah, blah. This is Family Tetris. So it comes with 2 controllers, obviously, and shadows everywhere, and that sucks. Sue, and I don't remember what everything costs, but I think, well, actually, it's probably on there still. Yeah, these are $4. And as I said, I went to 4 Goodwills. I think stuff might have gotten mixed up a bit, but whatever. I found this, and it just needs to be cleaned up a bit, but it's just got some like, I don't know, sticky stuff, whatever. But this is obviously the gold Wii Classic Controller Pro, and that was a limited edition one, and it's $4. That was pretty sweet, and all the buttons feel good, so yay. Next, I got this and this, and it's, yeah, SpongeBob. Fantastic. That's the SpongeBob SquarePants plug-and-play game, and I think I want to say that I saw this one on, maybe Metal Jesus Rocks did this, or Games Radio, one of those guys. And then I found this, which is also, obviously, SpongeBobby SquarePantsy. It's pants, man. It probably is pants, but I just like, and they're all like $4, so, yeah. And what else? This was pretty exciting to find. I see these and I always wonder what in the world, but I believe this is a Famicom, not Super Famicom, Famicom Pirate Kart 41-in-1. So I got that for $1. It didn't have a price tag on it. It was funny, this next thing I bought, which I was also excited to find, this is the Atari Flashback Classic Game Console with controllers that can plug in and unplug in. It says Mini 7800 here on the back, which I don't know, I meant to look it up and I haven't done it yet, so sorry about that. Anyway, right, I got this for, what did I get this for? $3? $4? Yeah, I think I got it for $4. And it's got these little deals here, and I don't know, it didn't have any of the cables or whatever, but obviously it's easy to get composite cables, and then I'll just have to look it up and find out which kind of 9-volt to plug in, and that's easy enough. That was really cool, but the guy was, like, trying to plug this into it. Because, you know, the Atari Flashback is just, it's all the games are on it already. There's no slot. And he's like, well, does this go with it? So, and I just said, yes, yes, it does. No. Anyway, and then the last thing, this is a cable extender for the PS2 or for PS1, it would work. And that was $2, which, I don't know, these are handy to have. Especially if you play with a PSX, which probably almost no one does. but the plugs are in the back for the controller, so. Okay, next bag of goodies, what do we got? So I walked into another Goodwill, and they had this Wii U game, brand new, under the thing. I think Grubgun picked this up recently as well. He might have gotten it even cheaper than I did, but for $10, I took the plunge on that. Because I actually do like soccer games once in a while, and I've got one friend, well, two friends, actually, who really like to play soccer games, or football, whatever, when they come over, so now we can do it on the Wii U. And the Japanese version of this actually has English as well, so I was thinking I would buy that eventually, but I'm happy to get this one new, because then I can get my... Actually, maybe it won't have points, because the American ones sometimes don't. Forgot about that. Oh well. I don't know. In Japan, every game comes with points, I'm pretty sure, if it's a new Nintendo game. Moving on. World Wrestling Entertainment Plug and Play. Yeah. Yeah, it was a good day for plug-and-plays, I tell ya. This was she gave me this for 99 cents. There was one that had it was a blue tag day. And anyway, so she just put this on there. It was $1.99. on the blue tag, and then she gave me it for 99 cents, even though it was for, I don't know. One of them had the blue tag, and she couldn't decide which one it was, so she just put it on one of them. Next, this one's kind of weird, but yeah, I bought it. Oh, this one looks like it can take batteries or plug in. This is Etch-A-Sketch wired. Oh, yeah. When I was, I don't know what grade I was in. When I was a tyke, maybe 5th grade or something like that, 10 years old maybe, or maybe 12, something like that. I have the Etch-A-Sketch Animator, which is a toy. You put in your picture, you saved it, and then you made slight, you modified it slightly, and then you could make animation with it. It was really neat, but I was into collecting baseball cards, and so I traded that to one of my friends for a bunch of his old baseball cards, which was a really good trade, but then those all got stolen, so I don't know. Anyway, I like Etch-A-Sketch, so there you go. That'll be fun to try out. Next. Okay. Another one. This is obviously Batman. Plug-and-play controller. I haven't tried any of these yet. Looks like this one was maybe $4. I don't know why I like these so much, but I don't know. I just think they're really neat. Next, I'm realizing that there's, oh, there it is, okay. I grabbed this and I paid too much for it. I will just say right up, I don't know why, I don't know. Anyway, I paid $5 for this, shockingly. But at the same time, in Japan, if I found this for 500 yen, I'm pretty sure I would buy it. And I don't think I'm really going to like it, but I want to try it. This is, I guess, a PS2 controller, maybe PS1, whatever, they're the same, so. And it's for driving games, right? So you're like, doing that. Yeah, that was, yeah. Next. Right, so as I said, I didn't sleep for over 60 hours straight, so today I woke up at 4:15 p.m., and that was only because I had to pee. What else? Yeah, I got this, and this is going to stay here in the States, I reckon. This is, as it says, AVS video cables, and you can use it for the PS2, the GameCube, and the Xbox, and it's got S-Video, I think I said that already, but they're meant to be good cables, I don't know if they are or not, but that will make it easy, because I don't have a ton of game consoles here in the US, but I don't think I have a GameCube, I should have brought one back with me, but I already brought a bunch of other stuff. Anyway, I did pay $7 for that, maybe that was stupid, I don't know. Moving on, and every time I went to a Goodwill, my friend has a club card, I guess is what they call it, and so she let me use that. That was pretty cool. Right, actually, I'll keep this one out there for comparison. Maybe this is for the PS1 because it seems kind of... I don't know. Anyway, there's that one. And then I got this one for $4. And it looks a little nicer. This one's for the GameCube. No, for the Xbox. So, there you go. Side by side. Once I bought one, I felt like I had to buy the other one, you know. But this one just seems like it's a lot nicer, actually. This one, you know, it's got the control pad over here, and I don't know. So I will be trying both of those out. Next. This game I used to actually play in the arcades, if you can believe that. And, yeah. It was $5 today. This is Golden Tee Golf. I actually have this already in a box, but now I don't have to take it out of the box. But it's got the thing, so that's kind of neat. I like my golf games, and this one's pretty cool. And I like having it loose, actually, so I can put it out with all my other ones. And this is one I actually hadn't seen before. It's kind of neat. This is a Konami one. The stick feels kind of crap, but it might be all right. Looks like it's a bit faded, perhaps. Arcade Advanced. A little focusage would be good. Yeah. Looks like it's got Frogger and maybe Gradius because that's... Yeah, I don't know. That might not be the Big Viper. I don't know what that is. I'll have to plug it in and find out. I don't know. Sorry. Okay, but I hadn't seen that one before. Ever. In a video or anything else. So I thought that was kind of neat. There's lots of Namco ones, right? But this is Konami. So that's kind of cool. And let's see. Now I have a bunch of, let me just start with this. My favorite movie of all time, maybe, Napoleon Dynamite. It makes me laugh every time, and I know pretty much all the lines, and it's just, I've seen it so many times. And I don't think I had the American DVD of it, and this I also probably will just keep here, but it was a dollar or something, so sweet. And then I found this. Oh, get back in your box, you. I found this. Well, you know what? Now that they're out of the box. In Japan, pretty much every year I almost buy these, but they're stupid expensive over there, like $20 each. Oh, yeah, but they're DVDs. These are VHS. And we have. It was my best birthday ever, Charlie Brown Peanuts Classic. I'm just realizing this doesn't have a Christmas one. Shocking. And it's got It's the Great Pumpkin, Charlie Brown. And I don't know if I've seen It's My Best Birthday Ever, a Charlie Brown Thanksgiving. I love these old movies. And not only that, it was actually a set. It came in this box. And it says here, obviously I bought it used at Goodwill, but it says free inflatable kids chair included. Oh man, if only I could have found this when it was new. Oh wait, never mind. Bam. Oh yeah, that's right. I got it. I got the inflatable kids chair. Woohoo! Sweet. Sweet. You want to see that again now, don't you? Yeah? Check that out. Check that out. I got all that stuff for, what did I pay? Where's the price tag? $3. Yay! Alright, and now I'm just going to go very quickly through some VHS tapes. Turn off the video if you hate VHS. I don't care. But I have a TV with a built-in VHS in my house here in the US. And I don't have any VHS tapes except for home videos. So, very quickly, I'll just go through. Once I get focused. Christmas Classics. This one, Raiders of the Lost Ark, not so quickly. This is one that we had in my family when I was growing up, and I watched it all the time. That was back when it cost a lot more to own a VHS tape. Miracle on 34th Street. I did grab some Christmas titles because it's Christmas time, and I might have some time to watch them. I also got Temple of Doom, and I saw Last Crusade, but I didn't buy it, and then I wish I had now. Oh well. And then I got some more Harrison Ford goodness. Theo. Screw you, Theo, for putting tape on that. Star Wars and Empire Strikes Back. This version, I don't know, whatever. And, yeah, I went kind of nuts on VHS tapes, actually, because I think they were 6 for $5, which isn't a super awesome deal, but I didn't care. I was just, you know, any stupid purchases I made, you can chalk them up to being sleep-deprived, or just stupid in general. Blackadder Christmas Carol, I almost missed that one. I was pretty stoked to find that. Shawshank Redemption. And where's the bag? I found a few. Well, here we go. I try to only get movies that I would actually watch. Pulp Fiction. Memento. Love this movie. Star Trek. Sheesh. Star Trek First Contact. And then here's Star Trek the motion picture. Special longer version. 12 minutes of new footage. Beejer. Return of the Jedi. Can you still see all those? Yeah? Okay. Star Wars, different cases. Oh, I can't show you that one. Sorry. I almost ruined a Christmas surprise. Yeah, I bought something for somebody else, but I can't show it because that person may one day watch this video. My Fair Lady. I love that movie. And Braveheart. Yeah, it's Mel Gibson, but I like the movie. And what else? It actually sucks that Mel Gibson turned into a jerk or whatever, because he was in so many movies that I really liked, and now I don't want him, kind of, because of, yeah. Why am I getting into politics? Never mind, I didn't say anything. What is this? Star Trek 7, Star Trek 6. Uh-oh, now we're getting out of, sorry about that, people. All right, get these out of the way. Yeah, it's a VHS extravaganza. I'm not taking these back to Japan, so I've got enough back there already. How are we doing? Not so well. How's that? Okay. Next, Star Trek 4, another great one that we had on VHS when I was growing up and I watched all the time. maybe my favorite. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's my favorite of all the original Star Trek movies. Well, no, Wrath of Khan, obviously, but I didn't get that one. Anyway, that one and Wrath of Khan, I think, are a lot of people's favorites. Next. MASH. Another Blackadder, which is cool, but it's part two. Whatever. I don't think I've ever really watched Blackadder. This one, another funny, not funny, interesting story. When I first got to Japan, it was 2001, and I didn't have a DVD player. When I went to buy my cell phone, I guess the girl who sold it to me thought I was cool or something, and she would come over to watch movies, and she just gave me her PS2, because she said somebody gave her one and she didn't need it. So she gave me a brand new boxed PS2. And so I hooked it up so I could watch DVDs. And I played games back then too, but not as much. And it played about half of the DVDs I put in, and that just made me mad, so I didn't bother with DVDs back then. And I gave that to somebody else who really wanted it, because I wasn't really into playing Gran Turismo and stuff by myself, and it pissed me off that the games are in Japanese and stuff like that. So I played an N64 when I first came to Japan. And Mario Kart and stuff. Anyway, going on. Here's a movie I've never been able to watch the whole movie. Like, I just always got bored at the beginning. So I think that I need to give it another try. And that's why I bought it. Because a lot of people say it's really funny. Okay. Yeah, after buying these, I noticed some of the cases are a little abused. But, oh well. American Beauty. Monty Python's Life of Brian. It's a Wonderful Life. I think we're down to the last three, maybe. Even if we're not, I'm done making this video. So, here we go. Taxi Driver. And Dead Poets Society. And then Platoon. So, I now have a pretty decent little VHS collection here in the U.S., and I'll be watching probably a number of those because I plan to just hang out for the next 3 weeks. So, gotta go. Someone's paging me. Bye-bye.